So we gather in the love of Christ, and we gather to pray over these our youth, that the Spirit of God may come upon them, the Spirit of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, that he may touch their lives, that they may be so in love with him that they will be witnesses of his. And the gospel today from the Gospel of John speaks to us of the Good Shepherd. And it says that the Good Shepherd lays his life down for each and every one of us freely. So Jesus, the Son of God, giving his life for you and for me freely. And as he lays his life down for us, he calls us into a very special relationship with us. He's willing to offer everything for us. Pour out everything for us. And as that Good Shepherd of our lives, and that's the prayer during this Mass, that Jesus really is the Good Shepherd during our lives, we allow him to truly touch our lives and touch our hearts. In the days of Jesus, the tradition for a shepherd was that they virtually lived with their flock. That's why the Holy Father said to all the bishops and priests, we need to smell like the sheep. Yesterday I was in Hattiesburg at a confirmation up there, and I can tell you by the time I got home, I smelled like the sheep. So the Lord calls us to really allow him into our lives and to let him truly touch our lives as our shepherd, as our leader. The sheep were able to hear his voice over every other voice that was out there. And so when he spoke, not only did they listen, but they followed it. They followed it. And they allowed him to lead them wherever he wanted to go, not where they wanted to go. And so the voice of God is speaking to us, each of us, in the future, right now. Especially to our confirmation candidates, and speaking to you to say to you, I love you. Jesus loves you. And Jesus calls you into a very special relationship as he calls each and every one of us. It's a love relationship. To let the love of God touch our lives. And to let the voice of God speak in our lives. That's why over these last few weeks and months and years, you've been children of youth of prayer. That's why you've also been youth of the Word of God. That's why you're in church right now. So let the love of God come and be poured forth upon you as confirmation candidates in the sacrament of confirmation. Just a quick story. I told it when I first got here, but I'll speak it again. A little over a year ago, I was very ill and unable to show up for my own Episcopal ordination. We had to postpone the ordination. And I lay in the hospital bed for a month. And what happened was I wasn't sure which side of the grass the Lord was calling me on. Who was it? And so all I had was the voice of the Good Shepherd in my life. I couldn't get out of bed, couldn't do anything, couldn't move. That moment was truly a grace moment in the end, although very difficult. And so that becomes the question for each of us. As we hit those things in our lives which are difficult, which are challenges, which we don't always understand what's going on, to let the Spirit of God speak in our lives. To let the voice of the Good Shepherd truly speak in our lives. And let that Spirit touch our hearts. Let that Spirit of God guide us and lead us wherever he wills to guide us. So we need to lay our wills down for him. It means falling in love with him. It means letting him truly be the Spirit of our lives. Jesus calls us to two great commandments as a sign that we are his. And those two great commandments are
love
Yes, I don't think they heard you. Try again.
Love God.
Amen. So love God with your whole heart and soul and mind and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. Even your brothers and sisters. I got you on that. Even your brothers and sisters. Your parents too? Yeah. Grandparents? Guardians? Aunts? Uncles? Teachers? Classmates? Yeah. So let the love of God touch you. So, within the church, who's received the sacrament of confirmation already? Look around. You can see how many have received the sacrament of confirmation. That sacrament is alive in all of those people that have raised their hands, people of God. The sacrament that touches our hearts in a very special way. As we enter into the sacrament, we are reminded of that first day of Pentecost, when the church was born, when the church received the Holy Spirit. And so, it's a very special moment. Letting the Spirit of God into our lives to touch us. And the Word of God says, the Spirit came with a frightening wind, with a loud sound. Most of the time when we read that, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Well, how did it happen? And so what it really sounded like was this. Boom! Does everyone awake now? Okay, the Spirit of God coming upon you is your boom. Letting the Spirit truly touch your lives. And the Spirit is right now over you in tongues of fire. And the tongues of fire are parting over you and giving you the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And those gifts are...
Wisdom, understanding, counsel,
I love it. It's great. So wisdom, knowledge, counsel, fortitude, understanding, piety, and fear of the Lord. All those gifts are given to you. And they're given to you in a special way to lift you up and to help you to be His witnesses, His disciples. Everyone that raised your hand, what gift of the Holy Spirit do you need this morning, today, in your life? Because it didn't end when you received confirmation. It began. So pray for the gift. For you, we're praying for all seven. That you may have the wisdom to know who God is calling you to be. And the understanding and the knowledge of God in your life, especially if you face life. And that you have the strength, the fortitude, the courage to speak Jesus no matter what. And to be there for people who are filled with piety, prayer, devotion, the Word of God. And the people who know God in a very special way and know God as an awesome God. That's what fear of the Lord means. We have an awesome God. He has created us. He has created you. And He's in love with us. And He calls you into a very special love relationship. So in a moment, I'm going to call you to ask you to read your baptism promise before this whole thing community and to speak your faith, your hope, and your love in Jesus Christ. Let me have the candidates now stand.